Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Super Smash Flash 2. Last time, we took on Classic Mode as Yoshi, and this time we're gonna be taking it on as Wario. Really quick, between episodes, I said I was gonna look up the trophy stand base thing, because if we go to our difficulties here, of course we have easy, normal, hard, and then insane. We've been playing through on normal difficulty, so all of our trophies have had a silver base. But if we were to play through on diamond, it would have... On insane, it would have a diamond base. Gold for hard, silver for normal, bronze for easy, and then if we use a continue on easy mode, it turns to stone. So, that answers my question. I should have just done the research previously, but here we are. Alright, so Wario's costumes, we've got, of course, regular Wario. This white and yellow color, that's really neat. A Mario Wario. The classic pink and blue. A lot of these are based on his Brawl colors. The green and brown overalls, this funky looking one. White and blue. Weird inverted kind of color. Or is that maybe No, that's based on his biker outfit, I think. This white, black, and red. Orange. Gross yellow teeth Wario. And then Wario Land Wario. That's awesome. Okay, let's get going. Let's-a-go. Yeah, we're learning stuff about this game as we go, which is... I like that. I did forget to look up the Crystal Smash levels. I forgot to look up if there's, if they're in Stadium mode and if there's multiple ones. But we'll do that, I guess I'll do that between this and next episode, and we'll have a new answer next time. Because I'm just learning stuff as we go. I keep recognizing stuff that I... or seeing stuff that I don't understand. I'm like, I'll look that up and I'll explain it next time. I don't know, I just kind of like that. And there goes Zero Suit Samus. That was a very well animated sprite right there. That was his standard taunt, by the way. We'll show his other ones in just a second. Team Goku! We're actually seeing Luffy in action. I don't think we've seen a fight with Luffy yet. Or maybe we have Chala Head Chala. Okay. Oh! That's not a floor. Okay. Up taunt is the wah-wah-wah. Up and down taunt, that is. And then side taunt is his booty shaking. And then, of course, we have this. As for his specials, we, of course, have Chomp. We have Wario Bike. Oh, we have his Charge Slam. Okay. Oh! Bro, why do you die the second you go down there? What? Okay, so Wario's probably going to be using a continue in this run. Because I didn't know you would die that quickly. I'm assuming we have... Yep, we have his waft as his down B. Luffy, stop it! What are you doing? Why hasn't Luffy stopped doing the punches yet? He's still... There we go. Captain Falcon stopped him. Alright, so I'm not going off stage even remotely. Because the second you go below where the stage is, you apparently die. I don't know why they don't give you much of a chance to recover on this stage. That's really strange. And, not something I've seen in any stage prior. What the heck just happened there? Oh my god, his down smash is just a punch. Okay. That's neat. Certainly different. Okay, so we lost two stocks on that fight. Which definitely could have gone a little bit smoother. Giant Link with Samus and Chibi-Robo on our side. Okay. Of course they had to scale Chibi-Robo up for this game. That makes sense. It's the same thing they did with Olimar in regular Smash, because Olimar is canonically the size of, like, a coin, I think, or something like that. Also, that was surprisingly easy. Maybe not the size of a coin. He's very small. He's, like, half the size of a GameCube disc, I think. So, he's a tiny little dude. The Pikmin are, like, the size of coins. They just had to scale him up a little bit. Have we seen this, this target test yet? I think we have. Pretty sure we've seen this one. Yeah. Okay, get that. Get that one. Actually, yeah, now that I'm thinking about it, we may have seen them all. I'm just unable to picture them in my head right now. We had this one, the one that we did with both Mario and Luigi. We had the pinball machine that we did with, Yoshi. And then there's one more that I can't picture, and I feel like we've done it. Like, my brain is physically incapable of picturing what it looks like if we have done it already. Alright, I'll be honest. Not a big fan of this Bomberman stage. I'm not entirely sure if... Okay, yeah, it does just spawn bombs in, which, you know, do what they would do in Bomberman. They explode in a cross pattern, and it's annoying. So, Not a huge fan of the stage. Also, Bomberman kind of left one of his bombs on the ground there. Is that just going to stay there now? I don't know. This is probably my least favorite stage I've played so far in this game. It's also a walk-off. Are we dead? Okay, no, we're good. We're good. Oh, another bomb. Okay, cool. I'm going to try and cheese Mario off the stage. God. Oh, God. Oh, he's gone. Okay, the bomb got him. Oh, my God. Okay. If we had died a little bit quicker there, Mario was in a star KO animation, so we would have lost. Also, keeping up with the tradition, Meta Knight is awkwardly raised higher than everybody else. That's the same in Ultimate. It's just weird. His artwork is higher up than everybody else's. Never quite understood that. In the thumbnail for him, I've already made all the thumbnails for this series, spoiler alert. The thumbnail for him, I intentionally just made his artwork a bit bigger so he was at least still, like, close to the ground. Because that stuff bothers me when the artwork is inconsistent like that. You know, so his feet are still on the ground. He doesn't look awkwardly like he's floating there. Alright, listen, I'm just gonna go, you guys. Because that move has been working really well. It's also just a fitting move for him to have. I don't know why... I mean, I know why they gave him Wario Bike. It makes sense. It's a big part of the WarioWare series. It's his freaking bike. He drives it everywhere. But his shoulder bash? I mean, I guess they did put it in his dash attack in Ultimate. Or maybe it was in Smash 4. But, still think it was a bit more fitting to be a side special. Maybe. Also, I didn't really mention this one, but his up B is the same. It's the little twisty thing. Wario's basically exactly the same as he's always been. In terms of special moves, at least, except for the side special, so never mind, I take back what I said. Crystal Smash! Let's do this. We're gonna get a different stage? Just this one. Alright, this is leading me to believe that there is, in fact, only two Crystal Smash stages, because we're on the sixth run of this Classic Mode now, and we've only seen two. I could be wrong. I'll definitely check, but I'm being led to believe that there's only two. Okay, do your up air, Wario. There you go, buddy. Kick that. Oh my god, the Crystal Smash stages definitely lag the most out of anything. It's a little bit aggravating. But not much I can do about it. I do love his punch, though. That down smash punch, it's very satisfying to use. He just looks powerful when he's doing it. Look at that. Success. How powerful does that make him look? Good god. Alrighty. Fighting Silhouette Team. I'm just gonna side B and hope for the best. I'm gonna see what happens. I also love that he comes out of a pipe instead of, like, appearing on his bike. But it just looks neat. A little purple pipe, it looks like he's kind of... He's too fat to be in that pipe, and he's struggling to get out. Alright, this isn't working quite as well as I had hoped. Maybe the downward punch? Does it ground opponents? Or, oh, it trips opponents. That's a bit weird. Okay, killed him with a waft anyway. Killed him with a Wario waft. Okay. Go! This move can also only hit one character at a time, so it's not really being that effective for us. Oh! We lived. Okay, don't use that near the edge, because you can't quite jump out of it right away. Okay. Downward punch, up smash. Why does the up smash send him like that? That's weird. Freezy! Okay, you're back. What do we got? Jirachi? What did you do? I guess you're like Mew or Celebi in the other games. You don't really do anything. You just kind of appear and fly away. Or maybe if I hadn't downloaded a completed save file for this game, it might have unlocked something for us. Don't really know. Alright, Super Pale Marth time. Speaking of completed save files, I technically haven't completed Smash Ultimate yet. I know I keep talking about how I still need to do the online challenges. I just don't play online enough to get them done. I also don't have that music track that you can only unlock- Zygarde, hello. That you can only unlock by having played a certain Kingdom Hearts game. I think it's Melody of Memories. I haven't bought that game yet, and I can't justify buying that game until I find it for cheap, just to unlock a song in Smash Ultimate. But when I do, I will feature that song in a Smash Sundays. Am I dead? I'm not dead. Okay. Thought for sure I was dying first. Alrighty. I guess it's not like Ultimate, where if you throw a bomb, it doesn't damage you, which I often forget is even a feature. But it's true. Here we go, versus Master Hand. Kinda wish Crazy Hand was here. Not gonna lie, I'm sure he'll get added in the future. But, I don't know, I think it'd be kinda neat to add him in, you know, to fight him at the end of Classic Mode. Also, I've heard rumors of an Adventure Mode coming to this game. I don't know if those are legitimate, or if that's actually a thing that's happening, or if it's just things people are saying, but I do remember hearing about them previously, like, when this game was older. I just don't know if it's actually happening or not. So if anybody in the comment section knows for sure if they're planning to add Adventure Mode to this game, please let me know, because I would be interested to play through that. Even if it's Adventure Mode, as in, like, Melee's Adventure Mode, I would still play through it. But if it's, like, a Brawl Adventure Mode? Yes, please. Yes, please. Okay, he's doing the laser attack again, so I will go over here. Because I'm on fairly high damage. Also, I think my waft is charged up. So, alright. That didn't do that much, but it's better than it doing nothing. Okay, come on. We can do this. If we can actually connect with our attacks. Jumped up to hit him. There we go. Why does it look like his foot smells? The color of that made it look really gross. But I guess Wario is a bit of a gross character, isn't he? So that would make sense. That would definitely make sense. Alrighty. Actually, I guess because it's in my brain right now. Oh, I thought we used a continue for some reason. I was like, why are we getting silver? No, we're not. We didn't use a continue. Hey, look at it. So that's what the sprite looks like in motion. I love how that looks. The Wario Land sprite. That's really cool. Alright, while it's still in my brain, let's just go check right now if Crystal Smash has multiple levels. Level 1, level 2. It only has 2 levels. Alright, so we've seen them all. Now, as for my question about break the targets... let's see. So this is the one that we just did. That's the stage we just played. Level 2. Oh, it's the dark one. How did I forget about the dark one? Level 3 is the pinball machine. And level 4 is this one. Alright, that answers all of the questions. We've played every possible variation of Break the Targets and of Crystal Smash. What about Multiman? Oh good, cruel. And they're evil! Neat! Okay, anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video... Oh wait, I gotta tell... We're playing Waluigi next time. Who's excited? Actual new character time, let's do this. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.